A story of unsung heroes. No glamour, no frills, just pure passion. Engineering, to most of us, gives an image of lifeless designs, monotonous equations, and noisy workshops, isn't it? But behind that picture lies a story of courage, no less than that of a soldier. A story of passion, no less than that of an ardent lover. A story of struggle, unparalleled by anyone. For the next few minutes, we hold the story of these five chaps and be the judge.
Ready, set, go!
And it all started with planning, thought, and as always, an idea. H.J. Mayang had a thought about making a robotic arm, a Herculean task by any standards. He began with a vague idea and described it to the rest of his friends. Skeptical. Skeptical about their chances at first, they started out with their paper. Apprehensive, confused, but determined, they started their quest. Target: to make a humanoid arm with 5 degrees of motion, capable of evaluating a human arm. It required complicated design, careful observation, and imaginative thinking. Merely rough calculations won't solve the purpose, so it required 3D modeling from professional softwares like AutoCAD. Design part over, it was time to arrange for the biggest requirement of all, servo motors. This was no mean task. Servo motors are specially designed motors for accurate angular motion. And the biggest problem? They are way too expensive and not available in India. With the total cost of motors exceeding 15,000 rupees, it was time to get some help. But one doesn't find help hanging on trees. They tried a lot for sponsorship, but all in vain. With doors closing everywhere, Alok decided to contact Professor Gupta of MIT Muzaffarpur. And guess what? Impressed by their sheer dedication, he agreed. Then started a series of discussions, calculations, and searches, only to get more confused. Abhishek, or popularly known as Chandu Bhaiya, was the obvious answer. Chandu guided them about MATLAB, a mathematical software tool used for programming purposes. It made their life easier. But bigger problems were still on loose. They needed servo motors, that too quick. One person who can solve this problem is Mr. Rohit, an alumni. He was promptly contacted, and as expected, things were back in track. Finally, some good news. The courier was received from US soon after with required specification. For such mechanisms, you need to have strong but lightweight materials. Balsa wood. It provides an ideal material, but again, it's expensive and not available in Varanasi. Story repeated itself as they strip search all their options and finally ordered a 30 cm thick plank from Ahmedabad. For rest of the parts like ICs, care boxes and omnis, they had to explore each and every part of Varanasi. A no mean task. Meanwhile, busy as they were in their dream projects, Ansem had trolled nearby. To make up for the lost time, they had to burn their midnight oil. Finally, a week later, exams were over and our heroes resumed their work in empty hostels. But where is the wood? They did receive the balsa wood, but 10 times thinner, and that too weak to solve any purpose. Their hopes were dashed, tensions were rising. 4 months of hard work was about to go in vain. But winners know how to hold on. They resumed their work with ordinary hard work, but with much more zeal. With less than 15 days to go, it was time to give it all.
Main kaha ye hai kya ho raha, ek pal hi hai chain yahan, dil ka sukoon hai kho sa gaya, ek hal jal din rehne.
Thank you.